Hey, what's good, y'all? I'm Newnue.
I'm Brandon Bell.
I'm Brandon Green.
And you're watching The Buzz. Have to say your last name. That was funny. Welcome to the Buzz. I got the double mint twins, Brandon Bell and Brandon Green, back on the show.
Yes.
So welcome to the Buzz, Brandon.
Thank you.
Me, Brandon Bell, not Brandon.
So many Brandons.
So yeah, we are still in the studio. And I want to introduce everyone to Brandon Bell. He is a correspondent for The Buzz. He's covering the music side of the show. He's going to be all around New York showing you different types of music, where the independent artists hang out, just the whole different side to that show. So, like, what are you looking forward to of being a correspondent on The Buzz?
Well, I'm also fairly new to New York. I've been here for like 2 years now. So, I don't know, just being a part of the show gives me an opportunity to explore more New York and the music side. I have a lot of music friends, so it's gonna be a nice little change.
That's what's up. So, you got any, you want?
Yeah. Do you work on music at all?
I do. I play the piano, so I grew up doing that, but not necessarily work on music. I'm a model, and yeah. So music, I don't know. I just love art, and music's like a really big part of my life.
Sounds good.
That's what's up.
So do you do anything with the piano?
Piano? Everything.
Everything?
Everything. Just let me put my hands on it. I'm good.
All right. Sounds good.
Got to
hear
them. So this show, you guys, we're going to talk about bros over hoes. I have a really crazy experience when I first moved here to New York. I'm not saying anybody names. But basically, the person who I thought was my friend, he chose his boo over me. And it wasn't like, okay, I can't go to the club with you tonight because I want to be cuddled with my boo. It was like, hey, you need to get out my fucking house. I'm gonna kick you off my couch. You can't live with me no more because your boyfriend is feeling insecure. His boyfriend felt insecure, so I had to leave. So I know that's a different scenario about bros over hoes. It could be something totally different for what you guys thought in your head. Mm-hmm. But how do you guys feel about that? Like, feel about choosing someone else over your friends?
I feel it's very immature in a sense. And, you know, in many ways, that person might not really value friendship the same as you do. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times we call people our friends that really aren't our friends. They're just, you know, people that are just around. And sometimes they might be there to help us get to the next place, but it doesn't mean that they really care about you and value your friendship. So for starters, you have to differentiate what is your friend, who is a friend, and, you know, and you got to know how to be a friend.
Right.
And I think that's the problem. People don't know how to be a friend. Mm.
I think with friends, you can't have too many. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I mean, friendships come and they go. But at the end of the day, a real friend would never choose somebody who's temporary over a friendship is a lifetime,
but
in my opinion.
On his defense, he was saying that he known him longer than me.
His boyfriend?
His boyfriend longer than me. Actually, let me go.
Explain.
Let me explain, okay.
The story a little bit
this
more.
This is how it all went down, okay? So, when he was introduced me to his boyfriend, he told me to act feminine.
What?
Okay, I'm not the most masculine dude out there, but he told me to, like, when he meet the dude, act a little more gay so he won't think that we're sleeping around or something, which we wasn't sleeping around, but he was just saying, hey, when you meet him, act a little flamboyant, hey. Call him a girl, do something shit. Yeah. So I forgot when I met the dude, I forgot to act extra.
I forgot. It's not you.
Yeah, I was like, hey, what's up, man? What's going on? And then the next day, you know it, the dude was telling him, was asking more questions about me. Actually, me and the dude that I was staying with, we got a little altercation about something that was so childish. We got over it, but his boyfriend took that as an excuse to try to get me out the house. Which I'm in a much better place, but it could have been the transitioning would have been more better. It wouldn't, the reason for me leaving his house and me crashing at his place until I got my house situated shouldn't be for that. It should have been for something totally different. I extended my stay. It could have been something totally different, but don't for not
risk
the
our friendship
for a dude.
And honestly, it comes, you know, with the guy being insecure. If your boyfriend is insecure, it's not going to work. So if you feel like you got to lie and tell your friends to act a different type of way, you got to look at yourself and think about it. Like, I'm compromising all of what I have, my friendship, my goals, and my morals, whatever, just to have you in my life. And I mean, what are you going to do when he leaves you and there's no Newnue to call and say, you know, hey, let's go get some like ice cream or something. You'll have no friends to run to and cry and say, hey, this guy hurt my feelings. You know what I mean? Little things, you know, you don't have anybody in your life now. Exactly. So I had a situation with like that over the winter break with one of my old friends. And it's actually the second time they put, I would say, a hoe before their bro. And in a lot of times, it makes sense. When you're in a relationship, things change. You can't expect your friends to wait on hands and knees for you when they're in a relationship. They have a person that they have to cater to and let them know that they are the most important person to them. So, you know, I understood those lines, but it would just be, you know, like silly things like, oh, you know, this he wants me to do this, or he don't think I should go out, or I've been partying too much. It was always, you know, what he thinks versus anything, or how he even felt as a person, even if he wanted to go out, and he knows his boyfriend goes out every weekend. So I just think some people lose themselves in relationships, and you just got to remain grounded. And in order to do that, you need your friends and your family.
You could totally relate to the bros over hoes because we have a mutual friend.
Yeah, I was young and stupid.
You were young and stupid, and we all been there before. Hey. That I seen this one of my friends, ex-boos or boyfriends, is totally attractive, and I fantasize or even try to attempt to sleep with him. You know, the younger days. Not now.
Okay.
But we can totally relate to that. So tell us about like what happened.
I don't want to put it out there like that. I'm not a messy person at all. This never happened before. I think it's just one of those things. Something about California and me being on the West Coast, like I easily like fall in love, I guess. I wasn't in love, but like
you was falling in lust.
Yeah. Lust, I guess you can say. It's just something about being in California. I think it's the heat and the water and no clothes. But
wait, did he look good? He's cute?
He's cute. He's
so
cute.
That
I haven't seen him in a couple years.
Well,
so.
What goes on in people's minds when we want to do that? Do we just look at the physical? Do we just want to have sex with them? We didn't want to steal them from my
see,
friends.
The thing, I knew him like maybe a year before we ended up running into each other in California. And like the whole, I didn't like him when I was in Texas. Like, he's cute, but I didn't have any of like desires, and I think I got to like talk to him.
Did he try to talk you into it? Who made the first moves?
I don't remember. We got really drunk that night.
So what happened? Because I got a phone call from a friend who told me about this situation. He said,
"Newnue, guess what? Ran and slept with my boyfriend.
They're not even together, right? That's his ex, right?
Yeah, they're not together anymore."
He said he slept with my ex. You know what? I'm at this. He actually called me when he was in the car. He seen you at the park. He said I'm about to beat the shit out of him.
Oh Lord.
He said I'm at the park. I see Brandon right here. I'm about to beat the shit out of him because I went through my nigga's phone and he seen y'all texting each other.
What was y'all friendship? You and that guy. Like how close you guys were?
We weren't close, but we were
cool. Light job, please.
We're both in the industry, so we like had connection like that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Well, yeah. So you didn't really feel like you did anything that wrong. It was just kind of like a associate.
I mean, I felt bad because it was his boyfriend.
Such a messy situation.
Yeah, it was a messy situation. Yeah. And I did feel bad. But at the same time, it's like, it's just one of the things
that happens
sometimes.
You know?
And what happens, happens. And I kind of went with the flow and I shouldn't have. But, yeah.
So in his situation, relating that to the bros over whole situation, do you think he chose you? Do you think he would choose you as a friend over his boyfriend?
No.
Like the long-term friendship? The long-term friendship, why? Do you think he could still continue you as a friend?
I mean, yeah, because he was in New York a couple months ago and we all hung out.
Mm-hmm. So he got over it?
Yeah, I think the whole situation blew over. And plus it was a couple of years ago, but...
Oh, okay. Time heals.
Yeah.
You're young, you know, things happen.
Right. You're just young, dumb, and just full of
calm. Full of calm, trying to get
it all out.
Hold on somebody.
Get it all out, baby.
Oh, I love it.
So how do you guys feel about, like, having, like, I'm in kind of a relationship right now. Mm-hmm. It's kind of, like, iffy.
Uh-huh.
But what do you do when you're your partner or whatever has his own group of friends. I have my own group of friends, but you guys are always separated because he's with his friends, I'm with my friends.
Mm-hmm. I would say try to keep it as separated as much as possible, because when people get to know you too much, I mean,
mean
it could
from
be
his
a
friends,
yeah, like his friends, friends and him and your friends mixing. What if they start dating? It becomes a thing where you have too many involved parties, and it might control things. For instance, if you guys get in an argument, now everybody knows that y'all are mad at each other because everybody's communicating, and it's best to just keep it separate as possible and intertwine on group functions, and maybe you guys can do stuff together, but keep it as minimal. You don't want to connect too many people because drama.
Getting away from the
I'm
camera.
Sorry.
How are you guys?
But yeah, I mean, yeah, I would just say in a situation like that, hang out every blue moon, but don't get too tight. Let's just keep it on a very platonic. We all hang out every blue moon. Don't want to be too cool.
But
with
don't
your
you want your boyfriend to get to know your friends?
I mean, I would think.
Or the person
I mean,
you're
if
dating.
It, if it's going to be a relationship, I would like to have my friends know my boyfriend. I would like to know my boyfriend's friends.
But
like,
don't have his number.
But yeah,
whose number?
Don't have
if
my boyfriend's
getting,
number.
I think if it's good if y'all getting to know each other. I think it's fine at first.
But
until you get married, that's when you got to know everything.
Yeah.
Well, I guess it's different for me. Do you feel the same way?
No, I mean.
No. Okay. Well, I think it's different because, especially if my situation is different, because I have a lot of whole ass friends. So if I talk to someone, they're gonna know that person I talk to. Every single person I started dating, I say, "Hey, this is so and so." Shit, I fucked them 2 weeks ago.
Right.
Like, damn. So that's what I'm trying to say. Make sure. What if I know the dude you're dating? What
you
if
know
I fucked him 2 weeks ago?
Right.
And then later on, you guys get married.
Yeah, that's not cute.
No, but it's good because it's later on, it will be serious. And I'll look past that. I'll like, you know what? Even though I had sex with him, y'all
that would not be good for me.
Yeah.
My insecure ass sometimes in relationships. Mm-hmm. I'd be like,
but then our world is so small and we live in New York. That probably happens all the time.
I mean, every day.
Y'all always go around in circles. Y'all need to stop
it's
that.
A big circle.
Look at this jack.
So I'm pretty sure if you date somebody, they already know who they are. If they in the circle, oh, so and so.
This guy, let me tell you this story. This guy told me that he had his best friend stay with him for a weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And he always, you know, a little younger, he probably still a little old now. But he been fucking around, stuff like that. And he been messing around with this guy. And he came over. And they still talk. So his best friend came over to visit, and the same guy came over at the same address. He didn't want to come in the house. He's like, "I've been here before.
Why
I remember this door."
He
said, "Oh my God, I cannot come in his house." He said, "Well, ask him, can I still come in and fuck you?"
Secretly, this is what I want to say. Secretly, that guy probably already knew that was his roommate. Already knew he lived there. Guys aren't going to put themselves in a situation that they don't want to be in. If I get an address that I recognize, I've actually been to another person's house and I've like kicked it with the other person, but I knew and I just act like I didn't.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, I mean, you're going to know. Ain't no way in hell you're going to get to that door before
bed.
It hits you.
Really?
That you're at the same
in the same bed.
This is the same. No, we did not kick it like that. No. Neither with either guys. But, yeah, we just like hung out and secretly he knew. He was just like, "Yeah, you have you ever been in this area before?" Little stuff like that. So he was trying to play me, but I just like, girl, I don't know nobody.
Just gave it up, huh?
No, we did not have sex. Let me just say that again. There was no sex involved. We smoked and got high. We all just got a little wet from the smoke.
So where can we find your information? All right, you guys can follow me. It's at Brandon Bell Model. That's on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, everything. So, yeah, you guys, be sure to hit me up, follow me, check out my campaigns, whatever I'm doing, modeling, politics, school, art-wise, whatever. I'm here.
I'm fucking this switcher. Y'all, I'm sorry. Let me be the first person to admit this is new to me. We're in a mini studio. This is some real shit. So I wish you could see what's going on behind these scenes, but my left hand is controlling this controller. So if you hear me talking, but you see him in the video, that means I'm fucking up the switches.
We're learning. This is a process.
this is a process.
Posing, looking at ourselves like,
okay. You know that there?
I'm good.
Can you get over there? Look at, okay.
Look at that smile.
Okay. Wait, how you go back? Okay, that's okay. Fine. TheBuzz. So, yeah, we have so many interesting topics coming up. Just visit YoBoiNewnue.com. The blog, the Buzz blog site is coming soon. Anything that we're talking about on the Buzz or any current events that's going on, like a regular blog, is going to be on our entertainment blog coming soon. We have a good publicist and a person who's going to be updating this blog site every single day so it can give you the latest on everything entertainment news, music, everything. It's gonna be
fashion, food,
drama,
messiness.
Yes. So you guys can comment below, give us a grade, let us know what you think.
Check out Brandon
and what's going on.
What's your you have an email address or I mean or site or Twitter handler?
Twitter is at Brandon Bell Model. Mm-hmm. Look me up there.
Oh, see, I did it again. Okay.
And that follow me on Twitter, BrandonIsMusic. And your boy Newnue.
Okay, got it right.
And TheBuzZNYC.
Oh, okay. Oh, there you go. Okay. All right, you guys. See you.
Comment and subscribe. For bios, pictures, and other shows with Newnue, just visit YoBoiNewnue.com.